Thank you, Bell Choir. In case you couldn't see, there were 10 members in the Bell Choir. It's good to have you back. And good to have some of you back who we haven't seen in a while. We're glad you are with us today. Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome on this first Sunday of summer and first Sunday when we have returned to a full regular worship service. We invite you to join us for a coffee fellowship following this service. Please take note of the brief announcements at the end of the worship bulletin. And a special note is the fact that we will resume an early service at 8:15 a.m. next Sunday in our fellowship hall. As we remember those on our special thoughts and prayers list, we ask that we add this morning Janet Bartlett. We learned this week that Janet suffered a fall last weekend, and she is in Memphis Medical Center this morning with some heart issues, and they said it's okay that we share that with you. So let us remember all of them on our list as well as Janet. Now let us respond to the goodness of this wonderful Sunday that we have been given as we join together in a spirit of celebration, worship, and joyful song. And in that vein, we invite you to stand as we lift every voice and sing.
Thank you.
service of worship. We gather here with gratitude in our hearts for the light of day, for the song of the birds, for having come this far, and for summer activities with those we love. As we assemble here for this time together, may we find a little more light for our way. May we, like the birds, be able to raise our voices in song. And may our love for one another become a little more perfect. In your name we pray. Amen. I invite you to join me in the responsive reading. We bid you welcome. We bid you welcome who come with weary spirit seeking rest. We bid you welcome who come with hope.
Thank you.
We sang the Johnny Appleseed song before we had our meal. Can we sing it or not? Or should we not try to sing it? No. But anyway, we talked a little bit about Johnny Appleseed and how he went about Ohio and Indiana and Illinois planting apple seedlings. He would plant the seed and they would grow and become seedlings, and then he would take those little miniature trees and plant them all over the countryside. And then as they grew and made more apples, those seeds made more seedlings and more trees, so they multiplied. The apple trees multiplied because of what Johnny Appleseed did. His name was actually John Chapman. And did you know he was also a preacher? So as he went across around the countryside planting apple trees, he also went around spreading good news and kindness and love and good deeds. And so I've been thinking about that too, how that just as Johnny Appleseed's apple seeds and trees multiplied and grew, that so did his kindness and love and good deeds. And it's that way with us. When we sow kindness or good deeds or love, it tends to multiply. If I'm kind to you, do a good deed to you, then you may be kind and do a good deed to somebody else, and then they may be kind and do a good deed to somebody else. So you see what I'm saying? Just multiply. So the next time you eat an apple, think about Johnny Appleseed and how he spread apple trees, but also love and kindness and good deeds all the way. Sort of what we're supposed to do too. So have fun in Sunday school. The youth members can either go join the Laura's class or stay in the chapel. It's your choice. But the rest of you have fun in Sunday school. See you all again.
Thank you.
good work of our church and the betterment of our community and our wider world. And in that spirit, we ask the blessing upon our gifts this day and those who have given. Our first reading today comes from the Hebrew prophet Haggai. In the second year of King Darius, on the first day of the sixth month, the word of the Lord came through the prophet Haggai. This is what the Lord Almighty says. These people say, the time has not yet come to rebuild the Lord's house. Is it a time for you yourselves to be living in your paneled houses while this house remains a ruin? Now, this is what the Lord Almighty says. Give careful thought to your ways. You have planted much, but harvested little. You eat, but never have enough. You drink, but never have your fill. You put on clothes, but are not worn. You earn wages only to put them in a purse with holes in it. This is what the Lord Almighty says. Give careful thought to your ways. Go up into the mountains and bring down timber and build my house, so that I may take pleasure in it and be honored, says the Lord. And our second reading from Diana Butler Bass's book, Christianity After Religion. Belief, behavior, and belonging are three intertwined strands of religious faith. Sociologists refer to believing, behaving, and belonging as three dimensions of religion. Religious ideas, religious commitment, and religious affiliation. Long ago, before the last half millennium, Christians understood that faith was a matter of community first, practice the second, and belief as a result of the first two. Our immediate ancestors reversed the order. Now it is up to us to restore the original order. Instead of believing, behaving, and belonging, we need to reverse the order to belonging, behaving, and believing. And therein lies the difference between religion as institution and religio as a spiritually vital faith. I again invite you to join me in a time of prayer and silent reflection. Oh God, we have reached that time of the year when many of us are thinking about taking vacations, traveling to the shore of the mountains, going to visit family or friends, or just taking some time apart for rest and relaxation. Such times are needful and good for us, you know. But as we enjoy our summer vacations and times apart, may we not take a vacation from our faith and this beloved community. May we still make a place in our lives for prayer or meditation or contemplation. And like Johnny Appleseed, living out our faith and convictions in the world, wherever our travels may take us. And when we are away, may we continue to hold in our hearts this united church and the fellowship we enjoy and the good work we endeavor to do together. And may we also remember that the needs of the church, monetary needs, the need for volunteers, the work our committees do, all these things continue even when we are away. And finally, as we take time apart, may we continue to hold in our hearts, thoughts, and prayers those of our church family who have special needs. It is those we collectively lift up in our thoughts and prayers this day. combo glands. Our hearts, our prayers go out to them. Such are our struggle prayers, and now we can offer the individual silent prayers and reflections in our hearts. Amen. Well, what could a 6th century BCE Hebrew prophet named Haggai possibly have to say to United Church members living in 2021? Well, I'm glad you asked that question. So let me acquaint you a bit with the prophet Haggai and what was going on at the time that he spoke. Judah, or the southern kingdom of Israel, had fallen to the Babylonians in 587 or 586 BCE. Jerusalem had been overrun and destroyed, including the beloved Jewish temple. And many of the residents of Jerusalem and Judah had been carried off as exiles to Babylonia. But in 539 BCE, Persia rose to power, and the king of Persia permitted the Jewish exiles in Babylon to start returning to Jerusalem. So for several years, the exiles who had returned to Jerusalem began rebuilding their homes, their lives, and their livelihoods. But almost two decades after the first exiles had returned, the Jewish temple still lay in ruins. Nothing had been done to rebuild the temple, the focal point and center of Jewish worship and community life. Many people kept saying, the time has not yet come to rebuild the Lord's temple. So the prophet Haggai felt a message burning in his soul. Haggai's ministry only lasted a few months, and the book bearing his name is just two short chapters. But the brief message Haggai proclaimed was powerful in its effects. And so this is what Haggai said. Is it time for you, yourselves, to be living in your paneled houses while this house, that is the Jewish temple, lies in ruins? Haggai contends that even though the people were working hard and striving to earn a living, they were getting nowhere. It was like they were earning wages and putting the coins in a purse or a bag full of holes. Then twice he says, give careful thought to your ways. He urged the residents of Jerusalem to go to the mountains and cut timber and begin rebuilding the Lord's house so that the community would once again have a place together and worship. Well, fortunately, we as members of the United Church are not faced with having to rebuild, physically speaking, our place of worship, this beloved chapel on the hill. But I think we can extrapolate some relevant words of inspiration from Haggai nonetheless. For instance, the time has come to rebuild commitment to the work of the United Church. One of the issues Haggai faced was a lack of commitment to the Jewish temple and Jewish religion. Everyone was focused upon their own concerns, homes, and affairs, and commitment to their communal concerns was a very low priority. During the 13 months that we were not having regular services here in the chapel, it was only natural that commitment to the church, church programs, and church finances would wane somewhat among some members and some non-member attendees, at least. Out of sight, out of mind, as they say. And some may be tempted to decide that after being out of church for 13 months, they can live without it. Such may be true not only for our church, but for many something missing in our lives. And again, maybe I'm preaching to the choir, and those who need to hear what I'm saying are not here. Second, Haggai says to us, it is time to rebuild the spirit of community. It seems the spirit of community had also suffered in Haggai's day. In my sermon report on our first Sunday back on May 2nd, I stated that the United Church community had remained intact. But as I have observed these past 8 weeks, I sense that in some respects we need to get to know one another again after being apart 13 months. Learn to listen to one another and intentionally seek to